after finishing my touring with Jeff Beck, which was phenomenal, going around the world for like 2.5 years, playing every kind of venue, packed venues, powerful music, I was re-inspired by live audience and the communication and the directness that you feel playing strong music and tender music right there. I would describe the music of Thunder more from the blues rock derivative side. When I think back in my life of Cream and the heavy hitters, I consider myself, I want to be one of the original heavy hitters to keep that music alive. So for me, I feel more the blues aspect. When I think of Mitch Mitchell with Jimi Hendrix, when I think of that kind of feeling, that's what I want to emit in my music. The best of 60s meets now. The best of the powerful drummers meets now. Frank Martin, my keyboard player, is extremely versatile in that he can do almost any style well. If we want to rock out in jazz rock fusion land, in Jan Hammer land, he can go there well. If we want to do a tribute to Joe Zawinul, he has a great love for Joe. Anything in those worlds, he's very comfortable. Then I can switch over into I Should Love You, which he played on that original recording, and he understands the funk. And then we can switch over into a tender ballad, and he understands that too. So Frank, on very many levels, can do almost anything I need, from a soloist on the synths to, you know, a great accompanist, and can be very, very tender. After playing with Jeff, you know, I'm very spoiled now, because Jeff was rocking and rolling hardcore consistently. So I chose Matthew Charles Hewlett because he's an up-and-comer, young little kid, man, but consistent and want to make his mark. So I chose Matthew Charles Hewlett on the lead guitar to smoke it and sing it and play hard. On the bass, I'm very spoiled by the great Rhonda Smith, who had traveled around the world the last 2 years playing. Funky and mean and beautiful and divine and the goddess. So the feminine aspect, again, is on me strong. So I think I chose Angeline Saris, who I call Angel Funk, to come and bring, again, the feminine goddess energy on the bass from the Mother Earth. And it can also be funk when we need it and pretty and can sing some stuff. So that's a nice feeling, a nice marriage, to sing some of the smashes with me and some of the background parts, the most beautiful, divine, Nikita Germain. She's one of the only girls I know who can embody that kind of power that Whitney had, who can embody a real knockout blow on like One Moment in Time, I'm Every Woman. She gets a standing ovation singing those songs, as well as things that we do together. So I'm really proud of her. So I have a really dynamic and powerful band. We cut a lot of stuff in Thunder live. Me playing drums with Matthew and or bass with Angel Funk and or keys. However, getting the feeling of a live vibe in the room, so I much enjoyed that as well. It's always fun to take something from the spirit of live energy and produce it, because that spirit's hard to get, so when you get it, you want to value it. We just got back from Japan, where we played the Blue Notes in Tokyo and Nagoya. And I love the Japanese people. They are so beautiful and kind and polite, and they love the music. So it was a perfect place to begin and kind of get the feet wet and kind of get the feeling of a new band and with reception of love and respect and kindness and enthusiasm. So Japan was just off the chain. The Thunder album and hot, stank, swamp music for your soul.